Ooh, level up.
Durance, do you take anything seriously? Or is the entire world just a setup for your idiotic punchlines?
The world is the punchline, Birdwoman. In all its weakness, would you kill the messenger?
Don't tempt
if
her.
If he were as annoying as you, I'd consider it.
Awesome. This is the RPG Check. Welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. So we've just leveled up, or our main character Theodas has anyway. These people were searching for this woman that they said, they claim was a murderer. I forget her name. We're going to find out when we talk to them in a second. And we don't trust them. I don't believe she's actually a murderer. I could be wrong. So we helped her escape. She might have given us some money. I'm not sure. Don't remember. And, yeah. I think it's done. As far as that, I think she's left. So they're gonna get pissed. They're probably gonna fight us. And this is actually the event from the demo of the game. I don't know if it was so much as a demo that you could play, but a demo that they showed off of how everything worked, the spells, combat, all that stuff. So leveling up before battle would be a good idea, generally speaking. The character looks kind of funny with what she's wearing currently. I love the way the cape flies, it's pretty awesome, even though it clips like that, yeah. I've been giving her athletics. Survival is good too. But let's just give her athletics. Okay, what we got? Body attunement. Okay, so these are our next powers for a cipher. I can take one. The cipher probes the mind and soul of the enemy target, finding the strengths of its defenses and stealing them for his or her own. Drains a portion of the target's damage reduction, granting the same amount as a bonus to the cipher. It's pretty good. Mind Lance. So how... It's a fast casting, this is good. Plus 7 damage reduction taken versus fortitude. Got a bonus to accuracy. Mind Lance impales a target with a lance of pure force, inflicting major pierce damage to all in the line of attack with a high chance of causing an interrupt. Again, another fast one. 40 to 48 pierce versus will. Could be very effective against casters, of course. Pain block. Provides an ally with a mental block on his or her pain, granting a bonus to their damage reduction and regenerating endurance over time. That's pretty good. It's a buff type spell. It's like a healing over time. Wild Leech latches onto some characteristic of the target's psyche and drains it, granting the same amount as a bonus to the cipher. Affects a random attribute. 10 points stolen from a random attribute versus... Yeah. Random. Yeah. I like the Mind Lance. I'll probably use that against casters. So we'll do that. Talents. Psychic Backlash. Invokes a retaliatory strike, stunning an enemy whenever they target the cipher's will defense. Does that mean we cannot be susceptible to will, or we still can? I don't know. looking at these really quick. Bloody slaughter. Let's make sure I don't have anything else selected. These have to be useful. Plus 6 shield deflection. Shield deflection bonus also applies to reflex. Let's do that. Done. Consider her leveled. Hopefully the others won't be far behind.
Eh?
Us? We're just minding our own business. We're cooling our heels until Medreth says the job's done.
Sure.
Oh, we're talking to the boar. Talk with Medreth, okay. Let's get in line. In a good stance here.
Eh?
Hello.
Medreth picks at a long blade of grass. Found Nyfre yet? That's her name. I'm ready to get out of here. What's this lie? Now, we were going... Yeah, the whole meaning of us lying, I think she went south. We're going to tell her she snuck out the back of the inn and went north. He squints at you, pulling the grass into two flimsy threads. Did she now? And how would you have known that? Oh, I want to resolve. I was just hoping you'd believe me. Medreth draws his blade. Don't worry, I'll catch up to her. Right after I take care of you. Here we go. Task completed. Oh, we got stuff going on at the fortress when this battle's done. Oh, we can all level up now. What if we die in this battle? Ah, taxes collected. Lost money to bandits. That's no good. Alright. She's already on him, so... Attack. Knockdown attack. Attack. Burning sword attack. And... I guess technically we're not in combat yet. They're just aggressive. Attack range for now. Now we're in combat. Cool. This'll go well. Ooh, chunks! Chunks of Medreth. Next target.
sit!
Oh, I was like, where's the dwarf? It just fell over quietly. No chunks from him. Fine warbow, fine mace, stiletto, brigandine. I want to take a look at this brigandine. Oh, they got vegetables.
Got it.
That was easy. I thought we were going to have trouble there for a sec. Just for a sec. Plus, Aloth got banged up. That's not surprising. Yeah, it's not what I wanted to open. A fine brigandine. Say I wouldn't want it. Damage reduction's much better on the fine brigandine, but it's heavy armor, that's why. Mail armor, medium. Kenna's got it. Hold on to this thing. I might enchant this at some point. Alright, done. Oh, actually, leveling. Yeah. Athletics is good. Helps with combat fatigue. Survival's good too. Level 4. Confusion. Infects the minds of enemies in the area of effect with delirium, confusing them. Confused only for 10 seconds. Dimensional shift. Switches the locations of the caster and one ally, leaving a shockwave between them that stuns all caught in the line of fire. Pretty neat. It just stuns, though. No one actually gets hurt, and it's only for 6 seconds. Essential Phantom. Ghostly double. Shock damage. Flame Shield. Engulfs the caster in fire, increasing their freeze damage reduction and causing burn damage to anyone who damages them with a melee attack. That's pretty cool. Plus 10 damage reduction against freezing stuff. Retaliate. When hit by a melee attack. For basically almost a minute. Yeah, how much burn damage though? Is it like typically? Wait. Damage types. Burn. Well, it doesn't say. I like that though. Minor Arcane Reflection. Flame. Generates a fearsome vertical sheet of flame, inflicting burn damage on anyone moving through it. I'm gonna take that. I like the flame shield too. But next time. You can only take one. How long does it last? 30 seconds. Five to eight burn versus reflex. What if they stand in it? Will they get continual damage every turn? Whenever it's their turn to go? I know there's no turns and rounds in this game, but you know what I mean. Will they get continual damage? Talents. Arcane Veil. Two per rest. Nice, plus 50 deflection. For limited time, though. Instant. Can keep him from getting killed so much. Grimoire Slam, penetrating blast. Seeing Grimoire Slam, concentrating the power of blasts, negating some of the targets. Passive. Alright, what qualifies as a blast? Like a fireball? Would that be a blast? Let's take Arcane Veil. Two per rest. Aloth, complete. Our cleric, Durance. We don't have a proper rogue in this party, so he's doubling with roguey stuff. So I'm gonna give him mechanics for disarming traps. Maybe he can go back and disarm that trap, that trap on the floor. I'll save the 2 points for the next level, because we're gonna need 8 next time. Interdiction. Condemns the priest's foes, dazing any enemies in the area of effect. One per encounter, nice. So I can use this crap all the time. Foe AoE dazed for 8.8 seconds versus will. Inspired Flame. The Faithful of Magrin. Gain an accuracy bonus with sword and arquebus. He's not using either. You can cast a special version of Burst of Summer Flame. Aggrandizing Radiance. Everyone receives less healing from the priest's holy radiance, but the priest gains a bonus to all attributes and movement. So 5% healing done. Plus 2 might, con, dex, perception, intellect, resolve. Plus 2 move speed for 12.5 seconds. Damage. I'm gonna take interdiction. When that happens. Durance! Adair, my friend. Survival. Weapon Mastery Knight. a second. I forget what he's using. A stiletto. I don't know, I like him with the stiletto because it's fast. I mean, you just chop, chop, chop. And that oid rect or whatever the hell is a pretty good weapon. Alright. So maybe I could just take weapon focus with stiletto type stuff. Doesn't include that. Maybe I already gave it to him. Hard to choose, you know, because what do you get hit by most often? Basically. Blinded and stuck type things, mobile attacks, paralyzed, petrified, stunned, or mental. Weapon and I could give him weapon and shield style.
Hey.
Does it say here what I've taken? Stealth, athletics, skills. Weapon specialization, knight. Oh, I'm losing out, aren't I? Wait, so what was showing up on his... So I might want to... That's talents, that's abilities. I might want to just switch weapons and give him something, one of these. A battle axe. Or preferably a sword. But, wait. Is a stiletto a kind of sword? Is it a sword type? I have to look that up. Is stiletto a separate weapon? Or is stiletto a type of sword? So I'm writing this down. I might... I mean, it might say here. It might indicate... Alright, I don't know. Finally! Oh no, we got two more. Just spend this whole episode leveling up. Huh! We should be done for a while after this. Athletics. Now, what kind of weapon is he using? I want to make sure they're specialized in whatever weapon they're using. An Estoc. I'm not sure that's even something that's on that list. Alright, what do we take? Athletics. I gotta learn more how to use these. Ooh, Will-O-Wisps, the fight for the party, I like that. Beloved Spirits. Improves the chanter's connection to the soul fragments they employ, increasing ancient memories' healing capability. Here we go. Weapon focus for Estoc. Plus 6 accuracy. Adventure. Let me just look through these. What was it I was wondering again? A stiletto. Weapon focus ruffian. Okay. Adventurer. Alright, done. So we want to give him weapon focus ruffian. Next time. That'll remember. Maybe he already has it. I don't know.
Hey.
I mean, we'd see it here, wouldn't we? Wait, nope.
Hey. Hey.
Weapon specialization. Oh, he has it. He's got it already. Well, never mind then. Alright. Whatever. One more. Wow, guys. Hope this isn't a completely boring one for you. She needs some survival. Athletics are up to the top. 2 ranks in survival. Well, wait, what's she using? I keep canceling out. I'm being very careful here, guys.
I'm ready.
So am I. A great sword. Okay. Greater lay on hands. Excuse me. It heals more. I definitely want to take that at some point. I think we should get her weapon specialization going, though. Critical focus. Allies notice the paladin's zeal and become thoroughly inspired by it. And deep faith. The intensity of the paladin's faith deepens, granting them increased defensive bonuses to faith and conviction. That looks pretty freaking awesome, too. I guess knight, because anything a sword. I'm gonna give her this. And we'll go to Deep Faith, probably take next time. Done! And what about our fortress? Major Adventure rewards 15% experience, average item. Let's send Firebrand. She needs a little action, I think. Quest expires in 1 day. We're doing well, I must say. I'm gonna call it an episode. All we did was fight these people and level up. But we'll be done for a while with that. Well, done forever with these people. They turned into chunks. And, yeah. We're leveled up. That's good for a while. I was wondering. I'm like, oh, aren't we getting close? It's been a while since we leveled up, so. Thanks for watching. See you next time. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.